Hello everyone and welcome back to Planet Zoo. Today we're gonna start on a nice franchise zoo, as I promised. Or a challenge zoo, franchise zoo. Yes, a franchise zoo. I'm really excited about this one. I only used to play Sandbox in Planet Zoo and Planet Coast for that instance. So I'm really excited to see what challenges I will face in the franchise mode. So let's name a franchise. And since I'm going with a Dutch park, I've decided on that I'm gonna name it with a Dutch name, which is gonna be Willems. So, why can I only write in capital letters? Willems. Willem is a Dutch name. William in English, I guess, or Bill. But Willems is also a last name here. So it's basically what started as a family zoo. I'm making a story around it, right? So what started as a family zoo is now going to be in a franchise zoo, but we'll start modestly with just one zoo, of course. I'm ready. Okay. Oh, I've earned leaves. That's nice. I don't want this picture. Can I change the picture? Badge. Now, what fits my personality? The lion is kind of cliche, isn't it? Okay, let's choose the giraffe. Okay, confirm. Let's choose a location. Now, for you guys that don't know, this is Europe. And in Europe, we have this little place here, which is called the Netherlands. And that's where I live. I live right here, exactly, in the world. So, we're gonna go with that too. So yes, I did also do the European temperate climate for the palace zoo, but this is going to be entirely different theme. So yeah, okay, zoo name Willems. I can make it in Dutch like Dierenpark, which means animal park. You see quite a lot here, but zoo is also a thing we use. So for the easy thing, I'm gonna go with zoo. Create. Oh, that already cost me my 100 leaves. Okay. Okay, now we're here. It's nice and flat like the Netherlands is, so let's just... Oh, I can't... Okay, so you can't change the time and stuff in franchise mode. I didn't know that. Okay, that's gonna be quite annoying. Put it on pause first because I'm really anxious about money. 40,000. Let's see what we can do with that. Oh, we have challenges again. Okay, so first thing we need is 1,000 guests. Or 300 guests, never mind. And it gives us $1,000 dollars. Or euros, because I'm playing in the Netherlands. Settings... game. I can't even change it to euros. This game is discriminating. I'm gonna put in a bug report. Anyway, let's start with the zoo. Watch some people I watched sparsely. So what I'm gonna do for the zoo is I'm gonna build like a modern entrance, but we don't have any money for that. So we first need some animals and stuff. So we're gonna build some small enclosures first and see how that goes. But we need staff facilities. Okay, all the paths are the same cost, so that's nice. I wonder how expensive they are if you increase the width and stuff. Let's build a staff facilities to the left here. Actually, this is gonna be the entrance plaza. Here is the actual entrance. This might seem a bit weird now, but it will make sense in a couple of episodes time, I think. Maybe not if we're if we're bankrupt, but let's not talk about that for now. Oh my god, we're already 10k in. Also, don't worry about it being ugly. That will also be fixed, of course, later. Why can't... So this doesn't make sense. So this is a building. And these are placed on the grid of the building, these paths. But here, they can't connect. Because, well, the game is funky like that. I'm gonna cover it up anyway. So yeah, that's why you shouldn't have to worry about the looks of it now. And now, immediately, I wanna do like something cool. But let's build the barrier first before we build the paths. Actually, is that a good idea? Let's build the paths first. I think I'm gonna speed up some building sections that I'm building in the game. So yeah, there's that. I want to work with lots of verticality in this zoo. So I'm gonna try. Gonna use this tool a lot. The stamping tool, I guess. That little tool. By the way, this commentary in between the speed up sections and stuff. It's all done after, so I'm here for the future or the past. But anyway, I'm just making a little trench area here. Okay, you can see what I'm doing. Okay, let's go back to me. Okay, we have glass, that's nice. Okay, let's place down some glass then. And then chain link should be enough here. Bam! That's our first perimeter thing. And now let's make it a bit more prettier. Lower these to 1 meter, 21 then. But the annoying thing is, because the terrain is uneven, we need to manually pull the rest of them up. Oh, I need the carpenter's eye for this. Is that a saying you guys have to? I don't know even if we have that saying. Okay, now we have that. Let's put the path in. Let's see if it works, actually. No! Do we have a tunneling option? Tunneling. No, that makes it ugly. Come on, my God. Tunneling off. Hope this works. Let's try again. Okay, I see where the issue is. Yeah. Okay, and then this one. Hey, it's working. Oh, I hate path in this game. Oh my. And we are on the top again. Okay, let's fill this up somehow. I wanted to as close to the path as possible because we're gonna place another path behind it. For that, I'm gonna turn on tunneling, I think. So, tunneling on. I somehow feel like this isn't the best thing we could be doing at this point in the franchise, too, but okay. Okay, I'm actually kind of proud of this, that this worked, so let's continue. So, double viewing area for the guests. Guests want to see the water, because there's only water in there, and I guess we want to see the animals. Can see it up from high. There we go, so let's see. Staff only path, and then boom. Not too shabby. Okay, let's open the park. Oh, we need some stuff. William Sue's open. Adult price 5. Caretaker. We need 1 vet. Mechanic. And a keeper, of course. And this is all you need to start out with, according to Palsley. So if this doesn't work, Palsley, it's your fault that my zoo is failing, okay? We need to actually order some animals. Animal trading. Oh, I forgot what animal that was for. That's for the flamingos. Like always, I also did the flamingo in my palace zoo. But I mean, they're cheap too. And they're easily appealing. And they are easy to, like... Well, they don't need a lot of space. I hope so, at least. Okay, where are they? Greater flamingos. Greater flamingos. Okay, filter. Now, I'm not gonna buy, use any conversation credits. I'm just gonna cash listings. What's the highest appeal? This one is. Let's get a mail too. In my storage are these two. Move to the habitat. And, oh, I forgot they need stuff to eat from. And, yes, okay, let's put a little area for them to sleep over here. And then they need... Oh, I, of course, haven't researched anything. They have water, and anyway. Put the football over here. They're the viewing point where guests can see the eat. I learned something from those tutorials. Yes, okay. Let's see how this goes. Oh, donation boxes. And all the facilities, actually. Like, starting up is the scariest for me. I hate this color thing. The heat map. The heat maps are cool, but not when I'm trying to place stuff down. Right here. Oh, we need power. Boom! I mean, you also need water, actually, so... Boom! And the donation boxes, where are those? Oh, I forgot to color them. Okay, so I'm gonna just color them black, I think. Now white. Oh, it's also gonna be a very modern zoo. I don't know, realistic. I'm really gonna focus on realism. Yeah, realism is very important to me. Well, actually, I'm not an expert on realistic zoo, yes. Yet. But I'm doing my best, so... Yeah, that's a very important thing about this. If you have any feedback on anything whatsoever in the zoo, my hair, is my hair correct, stuff like that, yeah, give me feedback and I will try to incorporate it in the next episode or the episode after that, depends on when I record and stuff. But yeah, I really would appreciate all of that. We spent $15,000, euros, already, there they come, with the flamingos. Now I hope as soon as we have animals, guests will come. Oh my god, it's a hydra. let's place down a research facility. Because that's what we need for research. Yeah, probably. That's why it's called that, Jure. Okay. Oh, the first guests are coming. We're losing money again. Why are they leaving? Why are they going home? Please give me money. Hey, there are at least some people watching them. Okay, this is promising. How expensive are these things actually, the rocks and stuff? Ooh, okay, that's quite expensive. Let's wait with that then. Now, don't worry. I know this is very ugly, but I'm gonna change it later, okay? Staff wages are too high. His wage. Also. Fat's wage. Also a bit down. Let's make some work zones then. The habitat. Keeper's hut and a staff room. Flamingo corner. Bam. Okay, so let's assign everyone to that work zone. Flamingo corner, flamingo corner, flamingo corner, and flamingo corner. Fat reaches complete. 3 items. Let's see what we got then. Toys. Oh, that's the big one. Oh no. Let's just place it down then. I actually like this for like a modern zoo. Yeah, that feels cool. Bam. Let's build some restrooms, actually. Toilblock. Oh, we're not making any profit. We're losing money. I'm gonna build one more animal then. Let's see what I like. I feel it's still too early for the cheetahs and stuff. We need something that lives in Europe or like can handle colder temperatures. But not too cold. This bear looks like a koala, by the way. Timber wolf. Minus 8 to 29 degrees. That's perfect. Yeah, let's make a wolf habitat. It went with a basic wooden fence for the most part. And yeah, I tried to make the shape a bit more organic. And then I tried not to have glass everywhere because that's not realistic. I just used some spaces to put the glass there and then I put a path around it. That's basically it for this habitat for now. Okay, let's go back. If I remember correctly, the zoo where I went, the wolves had a lot of privacy. They had these little peepee the holes where you can peep through and stuff. But we're just gonna place some glass down and then this should be enough. Okay, let's make this a bit more hospitable. So turns out the wolves don't like long grass at all. So I was struggling a bit with the terrain, wasn't really working that well. So I used a lot of soil and made a little pond to drink from. Because I think that's better than the fountains, they look a lot better. That's that. Put some boards around, yes, okay. Oh wait, they need food. They need food! Yeah, these I'm gonna replace with one-way glass later. Fat research complete. Okay, what did they unlock? Specie. Why do I every time have to go into this menu? It's so annoying. Okay, it seems to be going well. No, we're still losing money and I don't know why. Ooh, it's making a bit of money now. Hey, we got our first money thing. Let's put in the sprinkler. It's a toy. Put that there. Oh, they're new. Challenges now. Okay, claim rewards. Bam. This area here is gonna be the entrance building. And of course, we need like some drinks there. Place them at an angle like this. Okay, let's put the dog ball here. Block of ice they can have here. Here are a lot of people watching, so. Hey, the flamingos are doing very well. I'm actually thinking about raising this path up a little bit, the middle one. Oh, we have lots of litter. Okay, let's construct a bit more bins here. Walt Disney said that every 30 meters needs to be a bin, otherwise people throw it everywhere. Let's put a little food shop here too, actually. Boom. Let's put the prices up with 20 cents. I don't know what the best prices is. If you know what the best prices are for these, like, all these joints, let me know. And then I can put them to that level. But that's a lot to do with scenery and stuff too. But okay. Oh. Okay, let's put some hard shelter here for our wolves. I actually just want to do some rock facility. But yeah, let me know what you think would be best in this zoo. Anyway, let's construct a little area here for the wolves.
So yeah, the extended, well, not extended, just the roofing for the hard shelter. It's gonna be rock. It's all gonna be nature themed, at least for this part of the habitat. And I'm gonna put some soil on top and stuff. But yeah, it's all gonna be very immersive for the wolves too. So that's great. Anyway, let's go back again.
Okay, let's train these vendors because they have a high workload. But I think you only need one vendor per store in general. So I'm gonna train them a bit higher, give them a bit more salary, and I hope they can serve the guests faster that way. Because while they're lining up here very quickly, I hired another keeper because the other one has a high workload. But I think one keeper per enclosure is what you need. I'm not sure. If anyone knows how many like staff you need for so many things in your zoo, let me know, because I like to micromanage it to hell.
Anyway, okay, just let's continue with the habitat building. I'm placing soil down here on the roof, and that's not for the wolves. It's just to have like a natural looking roof structure. Also pretty modern. Of course, this is a front facade, and then the back of the building is gonna be, I don't know, like plaster, concrete, anyway, anything. I'll see, but yeah, I use some rocks here to really like give it a realistic vibe to it. Never only use like one supporting rock for the structure. Like use all the little ones so it looks complicated, even though it really isn't. It's just a pile of rocks. It's very easy to create scenic stuff with just the foliage in this game and the rocks and stuff. Also, the rocks count towards the rock terrain texture in the habitat for the animals. So if you're struggling to like place down rock texture, think it looks bad, then just place down the rocks. Also, yes, the pine trees. I use these trees, I explained further down in this video. I really like them. They fit the wolves very well, a very foresty setting. And then it's not that complicated, this habitat. It's just a lot of foliage around the pond. And then some fun stuff. I might do something more creative with the habitat walls later, or the path, so that it gets more interesting for guests too. But I'll have to see about that. Yeah, I also placed down these ferns here. They are also like found in every forest basically. I tried to keep to a very basic color scheme of like green green and brown, like a forest. It's not that complicated. Anyway, let's go back again. Okay, so now I have constructed here this little habitat, well, scenery for the wolves. Oh, one is in the box. But yeah, I chose to go with the pine trees, the Scots pine trees, because, well, you find these a lot in the Netherlands, especially in the forested areas, of course. A lot of our country is like basically agriculture, and it's completely flat with like kennels. There are also like some nature reserves here and there. And especially in the south and stuff, we have a lot of these trees. So I thought this was an interesting choice of three. And then I filled it up with the bracken and the ferns. And some reeds here. And I thought that would give you a nice foresty look to it. But now I've already saw that all the trees and the rocks actually take away some space from the wolves. So what I'm gonna do in the next episode is expand their habitat a bit into this area, and I'm gonna make like tunnels for them, small tunnels for them to go through underneath the path there. The flamingo habitat, that's gonna be also for next episode to like pimp that out. I just want to have some more money. I spent a lot of money on the wolves habitat now, but I want to have like 50,000 before we can actually build the entrance building here, which is gonna be huge. But yeah, let me know what you think of the zoo now, what we should improve in the next episode, and what animal we should add, whatever your thoughts are. Please share that down below. Also, subscribe if you enjoyed this content. Also, check out the Palace Zoo series I'm doing. That's more of a building time-lapse thing. Yeah, like, comment, subscribe, and hope to see you next time in Willem's Zoo. Bye!